But I don't know what it's wrong.
Breathe in the trousers have fallen off. I lost the story.
Yeah, he's only has lost weight, hasn't he?
Is this the way to do it, Barry? Marry your daughter. That's the way you should
do it. It's a good brilliant idea,
thanks
Barry.
Very much.
Oh, your hair does look lovely. It's really lovely. You mean things to bring in the jewellery? Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
lost it.
Getting the streets out.
Can you see it?
John, hold on, let me take a picture. Right.
Yes, it's your dad.
Down by the tree, with his parents.
Away from the crowd.
We'll get the others in, yeah?
Well done. You will do. Let's go with it.
Alright, get out of there.
Lovely jubbly ring. It's very, that's true.
Now, do you want to show them the property?
It's only a pound. Yeah, a jamboree.
Get your flowers. Yes, you do. Put the camera. Wait. Wait.
To work with this in the end.
Let me take that anyway. That's
bride and groom, could you please keep it well away from the door, and could you please not throw your cardboard boxes all over the groom? The confetti. The offertory will be taken during the signing of the register.
Could we have a little flower girl down just a moment, please?
Come on, come on, come on,
Maxie,
darling.
Hold her hand. Hold her hand, Maxie.
Oops.
Maxie, mine is dead. Bring her down another one. That's it. You stay there with Maxie. You two. No, that's it. You stay there. You hook onto Dad's arm.
Lynn.
Thank you.
Right, Mrs. Stevens, let's be having a come around here. You stay where you are and sit down there. I want Lynn Marie White. You have a lot of printing, ordinary writing you can do anywhere you are. Great. And again there, please. Photographer do his bit.
Alright. Yep. Fine, thank you.
Come over and bit tight.
As long as we can get everyone out when we need.
Lovely. All right. Beautiful.
babies. Look, the trees are dancing, babies.
It's a bit around the tree. It's excitement around the tree. But I think we might be having a little bit of a fight. Well, either that or we'll do the group. You're great. We'll get the pictures of it. We could be going and doing the cake shots. Would you like to tell me right?
There you go!
Lisa, Karen and Joe.
Hi, Joe. Lovely.
I'm
Hello. Yes,
Gina and Tony.
That's where he ought to be anyway.
Where he ought to be, yeah.
you now receive your bride and bridegroom, the new Mr. and Mrs. Stevens, Andy and Lynn. Let's
go.
Standing whilst I say grace. For good food, good wine, and good friends, O Lord, we give thanks. Amen. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. You're enjoying your meal. It is the bride and groom's request that everybody signs the wedding reception album. Now, I'm going to be circulating that round from table to table. What I would ask is, I'll start at the far end of the room with table three. Once everybody on that table signed it, could you pass it on table to table? And when you've all finished signing it, would you pass it back to me? Could you leave, please, the front 2 pages free for the top table to sign there? But I'll be starting with table three, moving around the room during the meal. Thank you.
Oh, I think I've read, sorry. Yeah, sorry.
I have read, please.
Margaret recognised me.
Merry Christmas and a happy Easter.
I do object to people watching me while I'm eating. Can I have a tea for them?
No insult to the bridegroom's parents.
Why not?
Mr. Stephen.
Well, let's have Esther on the table. You can't learn it.
It looks
like I'm good for it.
The golf club is the best golf club in the world.
I think about what you're saying, Mick, actually, if I was here.
You don't have to look at it, though.
We're not eating it, are we, here?
Smile.
That's dropped on the top table anyway.
It's lovely.
Jim, you haven't got a good side. You haven't got a good side. You haven't got a good side. Never had a good side.
Yourself away, Maureen. You're absolutely. Hey, do you know what? You and Maureen are disgusting to me. It's, well, not so much you, she's walking around with a lot hanging out, and you're walking around half your lot hanging out.
I tell you what, I didn't know it was going to be like this. It's obviously because I'm sitting down.
You're sitting on the wrong side of me. That's the problem. If you're sitting on this side.
Well, look, the big camera was embarrassing. I'm not joking. His eyes were going.
Good start.
Right, everybody ready?
And I couldn't work out whether it was because my necklace was wrong.
Okay, folks, here we go. Here we go. Gather up on the table. Do warn you. Bride and bridegroom.
Testing, one, two.
Bride and bridegroom, and a guest, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for your host, Mr. John White, who now has a very pleasing duty of proposing the health of your bride and bridegroom. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome John.
Pack it up. I'd like to thank everyone.
Is it on?
Yeah? Right. Now, I'd like to thank everyone, family and friends. Not on? Oh, don't keep doing this. Now, stop not saying it.
She's on.
You just have to shout.
Right. A bit closer. Is that good enough? Yep. Right, I'll start again. I'd like to thank everyone, family and friends, for coming here on this special day. Don't you dare.
I'm holding it up for you.
I thought you could take it away from me. Is it loud enough now?
Shout it out.
Right. Well, I ain't starting again.
We can't shout.
I know they'll be very happy together, and I'm very sad about losing such a wonderful daughter, but pleased to have a welcome addition to the family, namely Andrew. Andrew, kiss it now. I'm happy in the knowledge that Andrew will take care of her. I'd like to pay a special thank you to Maureen, for she has worked very hard to make sure everything runs smoothly. I'd also like to say what a pleasure it is to have Mum and Dad, Lynn and Andrew, to work alongside us in making today such a lovely day. And it really is a lovely day. Thank you. Right, toast to bride and groom, Lynn and Andrew.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. And join in drinking this bumper toast to your bride and bridegroom, Lynn and Andrew.
Lynn and Andrew.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Now let's hear three cheers for these two good people. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip hip.
Hooray!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated.
Thank Christ for that.
Well
done,
John.
I'm so nervous.
Is it going?
It's not that, is it? That might.
Well, I couldn't tell, and they kept making
me
worse.
It was starting me.
Andy, you're going to have to manage that tonight.
Lynn, what I want to say really is that you're absolutely right.
That's got to be fun.
But you can't.
That's all.
It's working, Andrew, you're all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, we tested it earlier and it was fine, and obviously something happened in between times.
Do you want to hear it again?
Right now. On a guest. Ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for a response to that toast from your bridegroom, Andy.
Thank you all very much for coming. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much for the presents and all the lovely cards. Deep breath, Mother. I can't really express in words how I feel today. I was very nervous beforehand, very nervous at this moment. But I feel a very lucky man to have such a wonderful wife as Lynn Stevens now. The thing is, because in John's speech he said that he knows I'm going to look after her, but I'm afraid it's the other way round. She looks after me, most definitely.
All us ladies.
Yeah.
She left off from you. She took over where you left off, Mother. I'd also like to thank my parents and Lynn's parents for organising it all. Obviously, they've done a brilliant job. It's a shame about the rain, but there's not a lot we can do about that. And the mic's gone now. So I'll shout it out. I'd like to present the two mothers with some flowers.
You get
the if I stick it in front of her, nobody about to see her then. I'm not giving my dad one, though.
More flowers.
Brian Lynn.
Did she? Yeah.
She's off.
Hands off, look.
You finished? You finished? Right, ladies and gentlemen, would you please join in me?
Join in
with me. Oh, join with me, whatever. To toast the bridesmaids, Kerry, Maxine and Carly.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise? On this occasion, join in drinking a bumper toast to the bridesmaids. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. And a nice round of applause there for Andy.
Oh, I'm going to go up and see again. Hang on, I'm finished. I'm going to give him a present.
Don't throw, he's great.
He wants it back, Steve.
Bride and bridegroom, host and hostess, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen. Pray silence now, please, for the best man, Mr. Danny Haley, who will respond to that toast and read a selection of the cards and telegrams. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as you appreciate, the microphone is literally packed up on us right away in the middle of this. Oh,
yeah, it's back.
It's back.
Danny's got a big mouth.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Danny tells me his throat is a little bit sore. If the microphone...
Oh.
Oh.
Where'd you go last night?
If the microphone goes on him again whilst he's speaking, would you please bear with him? As I say, we're having a technical difficulty at the moment. But please give him a nice round of applause, I don't know if he's responsible for us.
Thank you for the fart over. You're a lovely, very close friend sitting out there.
Sorry.
Hello. You have to excuse me a moment. I'd like to second Andy, the bridesmaid. Hello. Sort your daughter out.
Oh, she's
all right.
Okay.
Excuse me.
You want your attention?
Sorry. Is she all right? Right. I'd like to second Andy and say how beautiful all the bridesmaids looked. They did a wonderful job and done Lynn and Andrew proud. Now, this is quite difficult. In fact, I'm looking at one bit of paper. I'd also like to thank the caterers and the Prince Regent staff who have all done a fantastic job. I'd like to thank the... Put my hand in my pocket. Then. I'd also like to thank the photographer and the video man, who isn't zooming in too close. I'd also like to thank the parents, both sets of parents. I know done a lot of hard work to this to make this day a memorable occasion.
We haven't given the bill yet.
We won't talk money. And I'd like to thank Lynn and Andrew for persevering with the weather, the breakdown of the cars, the total mess up with the cart.
It was a cart.
And I'd also like to thank the vicar for being so understanding. And it's a shame he can't be here tonight. It's a shame he can't be here tonight to enjoy this occasion. I think Deep Rocking is too good for him. Now, I'd also like to thank Andrew and Lynn for asking me to be the best man. And you can believe that if you like. It was. We're all very close. Myself, Andrew Lynn, and my wife Maxine. But we do have a very good friendship. Now anybody who wants to know any further details, Lenny's got his own opinions. But as we're all married now, Len, that's not that on the head, mate. Well, for a while, till the heat cools off. As I said, myself and Andy, I've not known Andy that long. He was my best man of many years ago. Seems that way anyway. And we didn't get off to that good of starting our friendship. I'm going to refer to an incident that took place. A few of the people here know about it, but within a few months of us joining the group and being introduced to Andrew and Lynn, we was at, I think it was a New Year's Eve party. And hijinks got carried away, as they do. And it was a fantastic do. It was around Maxine's parents' house. And it was a fantastic do, and everybody was enjoying themselves. And it was quite an unusual do, because some of the boys were wearing ties, and they actually looked quite smart. Now, the ones that weren't wearing ties felt this was a bit out of place, so we decided to cut their ties. And we did the one that we wanted to do. Well, I won't mention any names, but I think he's here tonight. Well, he owes me a fiver, he can take it out of that. And then we decided to pick on Andy, or I decided to pick on Andy. And things didn't go too smoothly. It was arranged that somebody held his tie out, and I cut it. And this was just at the start of starting, I think, possibly to do the can-can, or something like that. Everybody linked arms, I crept round the back, put the scissors through, somebody held out the tie, they started to dance, I missed the tie and cut his face. He's got a nice little scar there, apparently he's quite attractive to some people. So I've been told. Anyway, so it did cause quite a bit of a fuss, and I knew then that we went upstairs and we put a plaster on it, and I gave him some styptic stick. Anyone who's known what that's like on their face after they cut themselves shaving, and he's talking about an open gash. But I thought it might. That's besides the point. I'll get back to the story now. Anyway. We stemmed the blood and everybody came out in sympathy. Martin bandaged his head and got more attention than Andy. And from that day, I realised Andy was going to be a valuable friend to me because he didn't...
He owes you money!
No, I didn't charge him for the plasters. Martin, there's been a request that can you come and get your daughter, please? Before she pulls down the blood. What, Dad?
We never
work with children or animals. I've tried the animals.
Just put them in cages.
worried about falling off the back of the stage.
He
wasn't. Where was we? Yeah, anyway, I decided that Andrew was going to be a valuable friend to me because, now if he'd have done that to me, I'd have sued him, basically. But he didn't mention anything. In fact, he introduced me to his parents at later occasions, and they wasn't too keen on it, but they accepted me as well. Now, so since then, our friendship has grown, and we've become very much closer. Very close. In fact, only in bed this morning. Andrew turned to me. And he snores, by the way. And I said to him, Andy, why are you getting married? So he said, well, he said, probably for the same reasons you are, or you did. I said, what's that for? Love, friendship, you know, relationship with your wife, affection, do the good things together, go through the bad times together. He said, oh no, he said, the married man's tax allowance and the mortgage subs. That's not true. But I'd like to wish them all the best in their venture together. And hang on. I think I was drunk when I did that bit. And I'd like to wish them all the best. And I'd like to end this speech on a toast to the parents. And like I said earlier on, they have put a lot of hard work into this. And I'd like to toast both sets of parents, Andrew and Lynn Senior, and John and Maureen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and join the best man in drinking a bumper toast to the parents. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated.
Good speech, then.
Nice round of applause, then, please, for the best man.
I got away with that. Right, like I say, there are a collection of cards. I'd like to thank you on behalf of Andrew and Lynn for all of your cards and presents that they've already received. And excuse me a moment, could we all say goodbye to Carly?
Bye, Carly!
Bye!
Bye!
Bye.
Bye.
Is Martin going?
Does he ever? Where did I get? Could you rerun the video, please? Right. Yeah, I'd like to thank you on behalf of them. Can you be quiet? On behalf of Andrew and Lynn for all your presents and cards that have been received. Unfortunately, due to the inclement weather, we can't read them all out. But I'd like to choose. They've chosen. We haven't got time, basically. Congratulations to you both and warmest wishes that all the years ahead will hold much happiness for you. To Lynn and Andrew, with all our best wishes from Janet, Alan and family. If I make a mess up with some of the words, it's not my fault, it's the diabolical handwriting. For the bride and groom, congratulations to you both. Love, Ron. And there's a letter to accompany this, addressed to Andrew. Dear Andrew, I'm arranging for this greeting to be posted on my behalf, nearer the great day. You may have heard of me, or remembered me, but in addition to the card, I wish both you and your future wife every happiness, but most important of all, good health. Love to your mum and dad. God bless. To you both. Ron. There's, I wasn't expecting a response. I was going to read it in. But that letter does mean a lot to a few people here. On your wedding day, Andrew and Lynn, 11th for the 7th, 1992. It's a posh little card. This is all satin and embroidered. Can only be from one person. We couldn't have wished for a lovelier daughter-in-law, health, wealth, and most of all, happiness to you both. All our love, Mum and Dad Stevens.
Most of all, wealth.
Oh, that bit was underlined. I understand you're retiring soon. Due to age, not wealth. A wedding keepsake from your mum and dad. I might try and read the front of this. How very bright and beautiful the world begins to seem when two hearts start believing in a very special dream. And then how bright and beautiful the world would seem forever as two hearts turn that dream into reality together. So dear Lynn and Andrew, all our love and best wishes on your special day and every day in the future. Have a wonderful life together. All our love, Mum and Dad.
Well, the other one was Mum and Dad Stephen. Is that any more Mum and Dad?
Oh, you stupid one. So Andrew and Lynn, congratulations and best wishes. Have a lovely day with love, Linda, Philip, Tim or Jim and Fiona.
Tim.
And Fiona.
That's nice.
Now, there was also a tele message sent. Congratulations, best wishes, and all our love on your wedding day and your future life together. Love, Mum, Dad, Peter and David. Now, I have a special telegram that arrived from overseas. But it's addressed to Andrew. And goes something like this. Dear Andy, they must be close friends. Unfortunately, I couldn't make it out last night. But, hello. Nose ointment. Unfortunately, I couldn't make it out last night, but I trust you had a good time in my absence. And again, unfortunately, due to other commitments, I can't make your special day. But it's written in some kind of northern jargon, so I'll try and translate it. It says something about he's got other commitments as far as his training starts soon, and he'd like to try and be with you in the future. And if he gets knocked out the cup early, then possibly he can come back and celebrate your wedding. Signed, Paul Gascoigne. I'm afraid that's all we've got time for, folks, so have a nice evening. Hope you've all had a nice day, and that's me off. Bye.
That concludes the speeches this evening, but there's one more formality that we have to do, and that's to cut that grant spending wedding cake that's on display at the far end of the room. Now, I know some of you got cameras and would like to get a shot of Andy and Lynn cutting that cake, so if you'd like to gather onto the dance floor, give them a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, as they come forward to cut the wedding cake. Thank you.
We'd like to welcome Andy and Lynn onto the floor to start the dancing. Welcome Andy and Lynn. Ooh.
No, not you. The other one. And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friends, I say it clear. It works. Hey? Well, we couldn't afford a new car. So what we got for you is a little present for you. Lynn's going away on for a full nine or eight. And you've got to go to work. So if you open that, you will see what you've got.
Woo! Where's their honour in Spain? Lynn, where's their honour in Spain? Where's their honour in Spain?
Where's their tickets?
I've only got a return ticket to Paignton. And one to Yarmouth.
Well, you've got to get Julia's work done.
I'm going to quite give her a quote. Give her a ring, send her 20 quid.
Please, champagne on the plane.
Is it funny?
Thank you.
swing, shake, swing, shake your body to the bop, bang, go spin, spin, shake, swing, shake your body to the bop, bang. Can you move? Can you move? Can you shake to the rhythm of the Latin groove? Can you move? Can you move? Can you shake to the rhythm of the Latin groove?
Back out a little bit, let everybody in. Thank you.